What's going on YouTube? I'm Slick, that's Slick Jackson, and if you're looking for the cooliest, grooviest content on the side, well, you've come to the right place. I really ain't one to get into the furry community. Long as they ain't doing no harm, I ain't really interested in them. Between you and me, I just think they're a weird bunch. You guys might think that that's mean, but hey, I speak my mind. They just ain't a group of people that I jive with, you dig? So yeah, furries, I ain't got nothing against them, but I ain't gonna say that I take a shot into them either. But you know, every now and then, you see them make it round in the commentary scene. I remember hearing a bit about some speech at some award show, some guy named, I think his name was Sonic Fox or something, who if I remember correctly, he kinda embarrassed the entire furry community with some weird spiel he went on. I also remember a certain Kira the Wolf. Now there is a rabbit hole if I've ever seen one. Hell, that might just be an understatement, but yeah, furries, they prop up in the cycle every so often. Today's kinda similar. Now, yeah, the story I got, it ain't that hard hitting. It won't be attracting the attention of major news outlets anytime soon. But that being said, I think it's, well, I don't really know how to describe it. I guess we'll just kinda have to get into it. You guys likely aren't familiar with a YouTuber known as Hypnotist Sapho, some sort of furry VR chat YouTuber whose content revolves around some kind of hypnosis therapy. I don't know, I skimmed through the content and I don't know, I don't think it's like a fetish. I think it's like some kind of variant of ASMR or something. I don't really understand that kind of stuff. It's just kind of weird. I mean, ASMR is kind of weird in itself, but yeah, I don't know. The content, it really ain't what I'm here for. Rather, I'm here for one specific video that seems to be gaining traction on the online sphere. Naturally, I found out about the video in question by scrolling through Twitter looking for my next story, and boy howdy did I ever find it. And before we start, I just want to set the tone for what you're in store for, so here's a short clip about what we're about to watch.
And I want to clear the air and say that, for the record, I am a zoophile. I do not have a thing for humans. I am more attracted to dogs like German Shepherds.
Alright, so now the video's kinda put into perspective. When they say coming out, they mean as a, zoophile, which, if you don't know, is a term used to describe people with, sexual attraction to animals. Now, I fancy myself a normal person, and I'm sure you do too. Now, you and I, we may not agree on much, but we can both agree that this just ain't right. Even if you never act on your inclinations, this sort of stuff just don't fly. It's messed up. That in mind, before we dive in, I just wanna say this individual does not represent the entire furry community. This coming from a guy who doesn't even like the bunch. Furthermore, it's a long video, so bits and pieces will be cut to save on time. Even though this is a person who, in my opinion, represents one of the lowest rungs that the human race has to offer, I'll make sure that their points are articulated fairly. That being said, let's start the video. Alright, sorry for pausing already, but come on. You're starting the video off with a sigh. That's like the foundation for every bad YouTube video ever.
Hi everyone. You all know me as Sapho, and I wanted to make a video about coming out. Coming out with anything can be very difficult, especially if it's something that society currently views with disgust.
Yeah, we 99.99999% of society view zoophilia with disgust, because zoophilia is disgusting. Shouldn't be any other way.
Or is a bit dangerous to even come out with the way that things are right now.
The way things are right now? Yeah, as if we, the general public, would ever move to accept this crap. Zoophilia is one of them non-negotiables. Not one step back, no compromise. Dangerous? Well, honestly, if you're openly attracted to animals, I'd say there ought to be repercussions for that. You ought to be ostracized from our communities. People like you have no place in them.
And it's a lot like when homosexuals were coming out in the 1960s, during Stonewall and those sorts of events.
Oh good lord, there they go, bringing the gays into it. I have no idea why these types of people always relate themselves to the LGBT cause, being gay or the like. Well, there's nothing wrong with that. Liking the same gender ain't the same as being attracted to animals that don't understand the concept of consent. Again, people like these pull crap like this all the time. They'll relate their struggles to what the gays used to face or some other oppressed minority, as if people don't see right through it. And now you kinda see why I played that snippet earlier, because now you see just how terrible and reprehensible this video truly is. Not only confessing to being something truly awful, but trying to justify it as well by relating themselves to communities that legitimately faced unfair strife.
And I know that 99% of my viewers, my community, you don't have anything wrong with homosexuals or gay people. You support them, you support LGBT, nothing against them.
Now, I'm gonna make an argument that's admittedly in bad faith, but I feel like what they're trying to do here is, or imply, well, you support LGBT, so you might as well support zoophilia as well, since it's so similar. Obviously, this is ridiculous for reasons explained earlier, but it's blatantly manipulative.
But I guarantee that many of you, even if you can't imagine it now, if you were growing up in the 1960s and were being fed all of the news and social propaganda about how gay people should stay in the closet, how it's unnatural and against nature, and all sorts of crazy shit like that, a lot of you would probably be anti-gay, anti-LGBT. And that's just how it is.
Now, how is this comparable at all? We're comparing people simply lacking the same gender to animals that can't speak, that can't consent, they don't know what consent is. It's like apple meet orange. And again, with this appeal for sympathy, this kind of crap never works. Ain't no one falling for it.
And I respect you all, and frankly, this sort of thing would have leaked out eventually.
I mean, would it though? All you really have to do is just not talk about it.
Especially with how cancel culture is these days.
Cancel culture, they're really bringing in... Alright. You know, cancel culture is more along the lines of you said something offensive 12 years ago, or the like. You know, losing a career over something that, for the most part, was harmless. We're talking about being sexually attracted to animals. Cancel culture, dude. I feel like that happens a lot. People get caught red-handed doing legitimately messed up stuff, and they actually try to spin it. Oh, the cancel culture mob is attacking me, as if most people don't just see right through it.
There would be people out there that, you know, they want to have a gotcha moment, they want to build their fame and popularity, and...
Ah, you see, we call this poisoning the well. Nice try, but I can see this crap a mile away. Seriously though, who do you think you're fooling? Yeah, the people criticizing me for being something absolutely deplorable, they're just doing it for clicks, they just want fame. You are a despicable part of YouTube. People are gonna be talking, for one reason or another. And me, I ain't here to stake no claim to fortune. I'm just here for the ride, so honestly, fooey to that nonsense.
And I would rather suck the air out of the sails of the rant sonas, and instead of letting this sort of thing build, just be open and honest about myself and my beliefs.
And you know, that's something I'll thank you for. You're pretty much handing this stuff to me on a silver platter. Saves me the time of having to do research and digging old crap up.
And I want to clear the air and say...
Alright, we watched this bit at the beginning, so we'll just skip through it.
If you are willing to stay and listen to my view and explanation, that is the point of this video.
Oh yes, please explain it to me. I'm just dying to hear all about the world of zoophilia.
It is to show that there are ethical guidelines. It's not so black and white.
Ethics and zoophilia. Good luck trying to convince me of that. And what, it's not black and white? I mean, it is. Don't whack off to animals. It's honestly that simple. Don't try to make this seem like a complex situation, because it really ain't. If you're attracted to animals, you're a bad person.
Zoophilia is often very misunderstood.
What, misunderstood? I mean, it's pretty simple. If you're attracted to animals, you're an awful person. Alright, so I'm just gonna save you a minute or two with this here. She basically goes on about how bestiality and zoophilia are two different things. Zoophilia, well, they respect the boundaries of animals, they never lay a finger on them. And to that I say phooey. You can try to spin it any way you want, but being attracted to animals, romantically, sexually, or otherwise, is messed up. And yes, you are still an awful person for it. I don't care about how messed up the other people are. At the end of the day, your fetish, and yes, it is a fetish, is wrong. Period.
People who force animals into situations they don't want, physically and through other means, are completely deplorable and seen as rapists. Playing with an animal that is not sexually mature is like the equivalent of pedophilia, and it's treated as such. I do not support those people, and they do not deserve the same title. They are fetishists and bestialists. I do not want them to be the face of the community, and they should not be the face of the community. It's like literal Nazis considering themselves furries in the fandom. You don't want them. We don't want them. We don't want that image.
Alright, you gotta love what they're trying to do here, trying to put themselves on the same level as, you know, the furry community. See? We go through your struggles too. We're practically alike. Again, it's one of those things that people immediately see and reject. No one wants you in their circle, no one accepts you, and for good reason. Don't even try to put yourselves on the same level as everyone else. It just ain't gonna work.
Ethical zoos are not like that.
No. There's no such thing as an ethical zoophile. It's as simple as if you're attracted to animals, it ain't ethical. You can't spin it any other way. Again, this is something that you just don't take a step back with.
Zoophiles are among the most caring and loving people towards animals and their mates.
I can't be the only person who's disturbed by the fact that they refer to animals as their mate.
We see animals as equals to humans, not as property or an object, like in the eyes of the law and others.
Well, here's the thing. You consider animals equal to humans? And I mean, they really aren't. Intellectually and physically, they just aren't. They don't have the capacity to understand stuff like abstract concepts and that sort of stuff. They can't talk, communicate, or articulate things. Now, don't get me wrong, I ain't kicking dogs around because I think I'm better than them, but to put a tabby cat on the same level as a human is just ridiculous.
Specifically, I and other ethical zoos follow what's called Zeta principles.
Alright, in the interest of saving time, the Zeta principles is a load of bullcrap. It's supposedly a moral framework for zoophiles. Again, I could care less about the fundamentals you supposedly adhere to. If you're attracted to the animals, you're messed up in the head and you should go to the loony bin. I don't care if you say there's ethics or moral frameworks, blah blah blah. I don't care.
Zoophiles are not the same as bestialists and fetishists.
It is a fetish. You can do whatever you want, use whatever tactics or wording, you know, do whatever mental gymnastics you can, but it's gonna be hard to convince me when I can clearly see this stuff for what it is, and ditto for anyone with a quarter of their brain.
Hypothetically speaking, I would see my partner or my mate as an equal to myself. Everything would be out of love, care, and affection for their wellness and well-being. It would not be to serve myself and my desires.
Again with this mate stuff, it's just disturbing. And not to mention that, again, animals aren't equal to humans. That's just how it is. Like, combined with your beliefs, I guess, your blatant misunderstanding of the animal kingdom just tells me that you shouldn't be anywhere near an animal. And luckily for the time being, it looks like that's the case. But seriously, like, I legitimately hope this person never comes into guardianship over an actual animal.
And a lot of people have issues with this sort of thing, which is understandable. I can understand the point of view that others have about my views. The biggest argument, of course, that comes up is about consent and what is that like, right? And they want to compare like apples to oranges.
Yes, we're comparing apples to oranges, says the person who started off this video relating zoophilia to the gays.
They want to compare a grown adult sexually mature animal to like a toddler, basically. In my opinion, it's a bad faith argument. I don't think you can compare a sexually mature animal to a not sexually mature human.
You can use whatever terminology you want. Again, mental gymnastics, I think they said, you know, sexually mature animal. The thing is, minors, like toddlers, are too young to consent. I know this is getting kind of weird, but they don't know what's best for them. And I mean, it's pretty much the same with animals. Animals can't consent, not even because they're not mature enough, it's because they don't know any better. They don't even understand the concept of consent. They can't comprehend it, so they can't consent.
My view on it is that if my mate came up to me, loved me, and wanted something more in that moment, why would I deny them that need?
Alright, this is actually getting, like, messed up. I don't even know where to... Alright, well, first off, how would an animal articulate the desire for, you know, this sort of stuff? Animals can't really do much to communicate, you gotta understand. Certainly they... Okay, this is seriously getting under my skin. Look, I'll say for the third time, it's as simple as animals can't consent. Seriously, the fact that you actually believe this is... It's disturbing. Like, I'm half tempted to say you should be ripped from your home and undergo some sort of therapy, like...
I want to care for their well-being and help them feel good. At the same time, if the animal is uncomfortable or walks away, that's a no. That's a do not continue.
See, this is the sort of crap that wouldn't hold up in a courtroom, human or animal. The only reason someone would make an argument like that is to plead legally insane, because no normal human being with a fully functioning brain would ever make a defense like that. Consent is a mature human being wise enough to make their own decisions, clearly saying, yes, this is what I want. Again, I honest to God do not believe you should be in any proximity to any animal with the way you're making your points. You don't understand how this stuff works, and it's blatantly shown in this video.
I have a really close zoo friend that can explain more in a non-hypothetical way in the second half of this video. And this friend has a female German Shepherd mate and considers her to be the love of his life.
This friend of yours should be put in the funny farm and have his dog ripped from his very ownership. Honestly, this is pure crust.
And why am I like this? Well, we can speculate on that.
Alright, for the next few seconds, she goes on some sob story about how much she loved animals. Again, we're saving time here, so we'll fast forward a bit.
My two golden retrievers at the time were my place of safety and comfort. And no, I did not do anything sexual with them. It was something that later on I had always thought about, but I was so ashamed for so long about being the way that I am.
And I mean, you should be. No normal human being would view an animal in that sort of way.
But recently, after discovering there's other people with similar feelings to me and ideals, it has inspired me enough to have this message. And that would include online resources, like through some internet forums.
So this actually reminds me of a 4chan green text, and I'm gonna read it to you because this is so goddamn applicable. Alright, before internet, I want to bone toasters. Don't be a retard, grow up. After internet, I want to a toaster, Google, find a community with 1,000+ members about people wanting to have toasters. And mess up your life. Holy darn, just replace toasters with animals and you have this video. It's uncanny how closely this resembles the clip.
And really what I want to do is to educate people about what it means specifically to be a zoophile.
Well, here's your education. You're a horrible person and you should be shunned from society. Man, it's like, I mean, this is common sense. Is this really what it's come to? Convincing people why they shouldn't be into animals? What a doggone world.
And that there are shades of gray. Not this black and white evil nonsense.
Again, no, it's pretty black and white. If you like animals as anything more than a friend, you're a bad person. It's simple as.
Comparing someone like me to a freak that forces themselves onto animals and—
Again, I don't care if you'll never enter sexual relations with an animal. Your opinions and it's horrendous, alright? But there's more to this video. The second half is some sort of interview, but frankly, I've heard enough. Ditto probably goes for everyone watching at home. What this video demonstrated to me is that this person shouldn't be around animals. Again, I'm tempted to say, without an ounce of irony or humor, that they should be ripped from their home and receive some sort of counseling, because this just ain't normal. Ratings on the video are disabled, which, you know, that's pretty typical for stuff like this, but the comments are still on, funnily enough, and if you ever needed your faith in humanity restored, well, the comments share my sentiment. Fatherless, motherless, sisterless, brotherless, grandpa-less, grandmother-less, aunt-less, uncle-less, cousin-less, just family-less. Please never relate this to LGBT again. No, do not even compare this to LGBT struggles. It's not when homosexuals were trying to come out. Holy darn, 99% of the community supports LGBT because it's love and sexuality with humans. Low-key kind of getting some homophobic vibes from that part. Just cause you don't act on it does not mean it's not disgusting. Exactly. Revolting, I have no words. You aren't coming out, this has nothing to do with the LGBT community, this is so far from it. You are confessing, not coming out, this is revolting, I do not understand how you think this is okay. No, people like you give the fandom a bad name, I'm ashamed. Genuinely wishing the worst for you, same here, buddy. I cannot believe people like these exist. Seriously, it just goes on and on and on, like... Apparently, this person uploaded a video in response to the backlash, and something I find interesting is, I don't know, let's just play it.
Hypnotist Sapho.
Dog fucker.
Has joined your lobby.
Alright, so like, initially they said, oh, I'd never lay a finger on an animal, and then they refer to themselves as a dog, you know, fucker. Which, yes, it is probably a joke, but it's still weird and contradictory, you know, considering how much they try to emphasize that they'd never do that kind of stuff. You know, optically speaking, it don't look good. I'm just gonna say that. Also interesting is that they list some of their favorite channels, most of which seem to be center or right-leaning political channels. I'm sorry if I miscategorized them there, you know, political compasses, right, but I don't know. I just think they're doing it to troll, and that's something else I'm considering. I mean, it's possible, you know, maybe this person's a troll. Hell, they uploaded their so-called coming out video on September 11th, which, Jesus. Although on the other hand, they seem to have put effort into trying to establish themselves on the YouTube space. So I don't know, I'm inclined to think that it's real. Maybe they're just trying to play into the outrage. I don't know what to think, all I know is, again, this is pure crust. So, yeah, it's a shame that people like these exist, but you know, that's the internet for ya. At the very least, people are coming out of the woodwork to completely shame this person, which is good. Common sense is prevailing, in some sense today. I guess to close it off, with stuff like this, it's important that we never compromise with people like these. You make one concession, who knows what's around the corner. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a line and it's clearly drawn. Well, that's all I've got for this shtick. Now, do old Jackie a favor and keep it groovy. Thank you very much.
White girls from dogs.